So today's topic is concerned with the heat chapter for the class 10th. The name of the point is dew point and humidity. Here two points are there. There are two different points. The first point is called humidity and second point is called dew point temperature. So number one, what about the humidity? This is the first thing. And then we discuss the next concept, that is called dew point temperature. But before that, we have to concern understood the concept of like dew point. For the reason, we have to know the two basic definition. The first one is called saturated air and second is called unsaturated air. Okay, first of all, we deal with the point humidity. What is humidity? As we know that the earth is surrounded with the 71% of the water, and remaining is nothing but a like land is there. So here there is a continuous evaporation of water is going on. And this evaporation of water, nothing but a kind of water vapors, they are mixed with the atmosphere. And when these water vapors are mixed with the atmosphere, the air become moist in nature. Means amount of water vapor present in the air, nothing but called moist. Air should be a moist. And the moisture present in the atmosphere, the moisture present in atmosphere is nothing but humidity, is called as humidity. Yeah. So what is humidity? The moisture present in the atmosphere is called as the humidity. Now it's time to turn the second point. It is called dew point. That is nothing but, it is actually dew point temperature. What is that? It is nothing but a point called dew point temperature. Before that, we have the two things we have to clarify. First of all, first is, what is saturated air? The first concept, what is saturated air? And second is, what is unsaturated air? सबसे पहले ये दो कंसेप्ट क्लियर करेंगे. जनरली व्हाट हैपन हियर, फॉर एग्जांपल दिस इज अ रूम एंड इन दिस रूम सम काइंड ऑफ लाइक सम एयर प्रेजेंट ऑलरेडी इन दिस रूम. सो इन दिस रूम व्हेन एयर इज प्रेजेंट, सो फॉर दिस एयर वी कैन यूज द वर्ड अ गिवन वॉल्यूम ऑफ एयर, मींस फिक्स लाइक यूनिट इज देयर, फिक्स वॉल्यूम इज देयर इन साइड द रूम. And in this room, certain temperature is there. Of course, some kind of temperature, for example, 10 degrees Celsius. And for a given volume of air, at 10 degrees Celsius, means I'm using a clear word, specific temperature. At a specific temperature, we have a specific amount of water vapor. And that water vapor will be maximum as per the requirement. So, two things are there. First, given volume of air. For given volume of air, means what happened here magnitude is fixed. Second, the most important thing, at a specific temperature is also very important. Temperature play a very important role. For example, for this room right now the temperature is 10 degrees Celsius. Suppose the amount of water vapor required, how much? 14 gram. Suppose it required a 14 gram. But in the summer season, same volume of air in the room only, but the temperature is, in our region, the temperature is 45 degrees Celsius. Now, the amount of water vapor which is right now required, supposed to be 14 gram at 10 degrees Celsius, is the same amount of water vapor required at 45 degrees Celsius? Answer is no, of course no. Some more water vapors are required. So the specific temperature is a very important role has been played. So for the given volume of air at a specific temperature, what is the maximum amount of water vapor? Maximum amount of vapors. If this condition will be reached, in that case, we can say that yes, the air is to be saturated. Suppose a given volume of air at a specific temperature and amount of water vapor will be exceeds maximum limit, maximum amount of water vapor which is required as per the temperature for a fixed volume of air. If it is present, then we can say that yes, it is a saturated air. It is called as the air to be saturated. And suppose for the same volume of air at that temperature, suppose the amount of water vapors are less than the required value. The amount of water vapors are less than the required value. Now this saturated air turns into the third point. It is called unsaturated air. Now it turns into the unsaturated air. When? If As per the requirement, amount of water vapors are there. It is for the given volume of air at the specific temperature, fixed volume of air, amount of water vapors are satisfied, it is saturated. But for the same volume of air, for the same temperature, the required value for the water vapors is, the contents are somewhat less, then we can say that unsaturated air. This is the two conditions. Now the question is arise in front in like mind of the student. What about the amount of water vapor which is somewhat greater than the required value? Suppose the amount of water vapor is somewhat greater than required value. What happened here? So here the reaction, it is nothing but the condensation reaction. So the excess amount of water vapor, they get condensed. Limit equal hai, saturated. Less hai, unsaturated. Zyada hai, remaining. Required se zyada agar hai, to condensation reaction hongi. This is what the three things. Getting? Now, question is what? What is dew point temperature? What is dew point temperature? Regarding dew point temperature, suppose for the given volume of air at a specific temperature, the amount of water vapors are less. In that case, what is the, now if for this criteria we have one word, it is called unsaturated. What do we have the word? It is called unsaturated air. And now it's time to convert it into the saturated air. Already unsaturated air, the air is unsaturated. Why? Because for the given volume of air at a specific temperature, what is the amount of water vapors are required, but the value is less than that. Now what should we do? As a student, in front of me there are two options. Generally this is things keep in mind. Number one, first thing, can you add the amount of water vapor? Add amount of water vapor. Hum log ek kaam kar sakte hain. What we does? We can do one thing. We add that much of amount of water vapor for that volume of air, for that temperature, it should be satisfied. Then it is turned to the saturated. Or what is the second way? This is the second way. We decrease the temperature. Why? We decrease the temperature up to that level, in that until for that volume of air, already vapors are there. Whatever the amount of water vapors are there, that water vapors are satisfied for that volume of air. So you have to decrease the temperature up to that point. And in between these two way, we follow the second way. So what we do is, we just decrease the temperature of that given volume of air up to that limit where the air get saturated in the required amount of water vapors are there. This is what the concept called dew point temperature. Okay.